الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا مولانا محمد عبده ورسوله فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين Respected Ulama Ikram and my dear brothers, first we have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Allah ta'ala's numerous blessings upon us and the greatest ni'mat Allah has given us is the great ni'mat of Iman. Allah ta'ala granted the tawfiq of maintaining this Iman, strengthening this Iman and leaving this world with this Iman. Nobody's Iman is guaranteed. That was every Sahabi, the chosen people to be the companions of our beloved Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam with Iman, they too until the very, very last moment had this concern and fikr that we must not leave this world without Iman. And that is why we advise most of our Kabirin, our elders, advisors, daily make two rakas surat salat shukr for this Iman and make dua, Ya Allah, let me maintain this Iman, let me increase this Iman. Once one of our Akabirin Uzruganideen, Hazrat Siddiq Sahib Rahmatullah Alayhi, mentioned him to make dua. The dua he made that time, he didn't strike me. He said, until the day of Qiyamah, Allah Ta'ala keep Iman in your children, in your progeny. It seems very, very superficial. But if you look at, that is the object of our life. That is why we have come into this world. And for this Iman, Allah has given us our great Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. And this beautiful Sharia of Islam, that whatever challenges will come upon mankind, Allah has made it so that similar challenges came to the Sahaba kiram in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam. That is why Hazrat Moulana Raipuri Rahmatullah writes that the Sahaba Kiram, the chosen companions of Rasulullah Sallallahu at certain time they were made to make certain guna from the taqweeni point of view from Allah Ta'ala's side. And the reason is this, that there should be an example for the Ummah, a practical example for the Ummah. That whatever a person goes through, how to come up from the difficulty we are in. Whatever sudut our Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, and every Nabi is masoom. It is our akidah and belief that a Nabi cannot sin. But we in human nature are full of sins. If we sin, what are we going to do? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it so that certain sahaba kiram were made to do certain sins. And in that sin, then they made tawbah and turned towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why when one lady, who by mistake or by human nature, made a mistake of being engaged in adultery, and the time of hudud came, and somebody said certain words that she had committed certain evil act, what did our beloved Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam say? That لَقَدْ تَعَبَتْ تَوْبَةً. She has made such a tawbah that if the whole of Medina was given the tawbah, it was enough for them. So our Sharia is a complete Sharia. The lives of the Sahaba Ikram are so important to us. That is why it is very wrong to use stories of the Sahaba. There's no stories. These were incidents that are made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as an example to us. That when your difficulty will come, When you will come in certain conditions of nature, what to do? Today we know throughout the world, the four corners of the world, there are two targets. One is to remove haya and sharam from our lives. that haya must not remain. If you look, those people, elderly people, 40, 50 years ago, would know that even a non-Muslim lady had sharam in haya in her. Her dress was separate. The type of cloth they used to be a thick type of cloth. And there was shame in haya in those people too. And of course, more importantly, there's a direct attack on iman. Because iman, Islam is the only religion that is really existing. From the asma, from all the samavi religions, asmani religions. As far as the Judaism is concerned, it's more a cult. Christianity, nothing is renamed. And besides that, Allah Ta'ala said also in the Deen and in the Islam, Allah Ta'ala did not want the existence of those religions after a certain period of time. Because when Iman and Islam came, and our beloved Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam came, then everything before Nabi alayhi salam was abrogated. Now only the Deen of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam will be a means of our success till the day of Qiyamah. That is why the ulama have written, Khatmi Nubuwwat, from this point of view that no Nabi is to come, is an integral part of our Iman. But one meaning of Khatmi Nubuwwat is also just as Mawlana Qasim Nanoti rahmatullahi alayhi. Whatever kamalat and perfections were in the previous Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, all those perfections and kamalat of the previous Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam also, Allah made it so that it came through the ruh of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. So we are so fortunate that we are in the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So whatever challenges will come, we have to see how did our Lord Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam revert to them. And that is why I know that it is so important for ourselves that my colleague Mullah Burhan has recited the ayat of the Quran Kareem, but that Mukunum as Sadiqeen, that look for those ulama who are on haq, who remind us of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and stay in the company. And there is Hadhrat Thani rahmatullahi written that if we are in a place we don't have the company, then read the kitabs of these great people, the Mawaizah of Thani rahmatullahi, the Fazail Amal, and all these are great Akkabirin and Musruqanideen. Millions of people have brought Iman and Islam to them. Here at this particular time, our object of getting together, we are here to listen to our senior Hazrat Mawlana Abdul Hamid Sahab. Majlis Zillah Allah Ta'ala give him a long life of Iman so that we can benefit from him. Allah protect him in every way. Very few words I will say, inshallah, just to show how important it is for us to align ourselves with our great people, with our Qabirin and Muzrugan and Deen from the life of the Sahaba Kiram. In the time of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, after Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam left this world, we know what a difficult time came upon the Ummah. Many, many conditions came in the life of the Sahaba Kiram is a perfect example what to do in those particular conditions. One great challenge came at that particular time that people were instigated from the family of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It shows that they will all be instigated from the back. That is how shaitan works. And they came and some of them, they asked, not knowing that Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam from Fadak, which is a particular place near Khaybar, and from Khaybar, the land that belonged to the Jews, in 70 of Hijrah came under Iman and Islam, that should go into inheritance and be distributed to the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it's a very difficult time. And among the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, first and foremost are the Ummahatul Mumineen, they're the families. Then the children, the daughters of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, and that time only the Fatima radiallahu ta'ala was living. The other three beautiful daughters of Rasulullah had left this world. The sons also had left the world. So it was a very, very difficult time. And some of them said that the inheritance is the law of the Quran, that the inheritance must come to us. Siddiq Akbar radiallahu ta'ala, we can imagine, then from all four sides, the enemies were working. The hypocrites in Medina Munawwara, the Jews who were all waiting for an opportunity, the big powers of that particular time who were waiting for Rasulullah to leave this world. And then from within the family, some people thinking that the book of Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala is not giving them the share from the inheritance of Rasulullah. So Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, at that particular time, he said that this particular land, Fadak, or what came from Khaybar, it was the habit of Rasulullah from first and foremost that Nabi alayhi salatu said, Namnushna Mashalul Anbiya, we are the Anbiya's Jamaat. And the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam are alive in the Qabr, so there's no question of inheritance. And it's our Aqeedah and belief that Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam are alive in the Qabr. That is why we say that sand that produced the beautiful body of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. That sand is more valuable than the Kaabatullah. Because Allah Ta'ala is free from space. Allah is no jism. Allah is, has been and will be forever. Allah is beyond the imagination of man. But Rasulullah was a human being. So that sand that touches the body of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, that sand also is very, very valuable. So we can imagine what love Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq had for Rasulullah wasalam. And the sacrifice he made to be with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and for the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he said, I heard from Nabi alayhi sallallahu alaihi wasallam that the Anbiya alayhi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there is no inheritance. Their inheritance is ilm. Their inheritance is taklif and making the effort of the deen. Lam yuwarisu dinaran wala dirhaman. Yes, in this particular land, Nabi alayhi sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to take out some portion for the expense of the family for the year, that will continue. When Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq left the world, after some time, Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, Hazrat Abbas radiallahu ta'ala came to Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq left the world. Now their request was this, that this belongs, of course, does not belong to us, it is waqf. But sometimes we have a difference in opinion. Hazrat Abbas says something else, and Hazrat Abbas was the uncle. Hazrat Ali says something else. So now the only way is this, it can't be distributed. Half the property Hazrat Abbas will look after. Half of it Hazrat Ali will look after. What did Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu say? Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu said that before me there were two people. One is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Rasulullah sallallahu took the expense of his family from this particular land. And he did not distribute it and not make them leak and ownership to any of his family members. After he left, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala came. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala also did exactly what Rasulullah SAW did. And he said, these are the two people, we will follow them in whatever they do. They cannot do something incorrect. He also did not distribute it. Yes, the family members, whatever the expenditure is, it was given in time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi was given in time of Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu sallam, that expenditure is given. Now you have a difference of opinion that we should not distribute the land, make half here and half there. Tomorrow, in your progeny, conditions will come, then some will say, this belonged to our grandfather, some say, well, this belonged to our grandfather. And consequently, Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu also, when he became the Khalifa, did exactly what Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq did, what Hazrat Umar did, what Hazrat Usman radiallahu anhu did. And then after Hazrat Hassan radiallahu anhu did exactly the same. The important thing to mention here was this, that Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu mentioned that what Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq did, what Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam did, that is the way we will follow. We will not go and deviate from that particular way. The way of Akabirin, the way of the Akabirin, they were the Akabirin of that particular time. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam had so much love for every Sahabi, you know. But his love for Hazrat Abu Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala was something different. In the Kitab of Hadith, an example too. The Sahaba kinam were human, so they had arguments too. And his arguments were there to show us, if you have an argument, what to do, how to overcome your arguments. Because you are not finished us. You have your egos too, conditions will come. So there was an incident in time. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq, Hazrat Umar had an argument. And because of the argument, Hazrat Umar walked away. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq went behind him, but Hazrat Umar was ever angry too. And we know the anger of Umar radiallahu anhu for Allah also what he did. A very, very strong person as far as nature is concerned. But the moment he came home, he really thought, no, Abu Bakr was coming to me. Let me go back to him, and now let me ask for maafi. In the meantime, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu immediately came to Rasulullah sallam. And he came in the company of Rasulullah sallam. From far Nabi sallam said, I can see that Abu Bakr seems to have a problem with someone. There was nature of maybe does not even know ghaib. You don't know ghaib of the unseen is only in Allah Ta'ala knows. But signs are there. When clouds come, we say rain is coming, it's not ghaib, ilm al-ghaib. You can see the signs of rain. So he said, it seems there's a difference of someone. And then Hazrat Umar and Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq came and told, Ya Rasulullah, I had a difference with Umar. I wanted to ask him to forgive us. Hazrat Umar was a bit angry. He went away. In the meantime, Hazrat Umar came. When Hazrat Umar came, Nabi alayhi salam rose with respect, and Nabi alayhi salam said, if there was a Nabi after me, it would be Umar. Nabi alayhi salam said, the road Umar goes, Shaitan does not take that particular path. So many ayat of the Quran al-Kareem. But he said, he became angry on Hazrat Umar. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq kept on saying, Ya Rasulullah, it was my mistake. Ya Rasulullah, it was my mistake. But Hazrat Nabi alayhi salam said that what? I came with this da'wat. I offered this da'wat. Everyone refused. And Abu Bakr accepted. He did not ask me for any proof. So it shows those that are elderly people, the road that they take, the road that they take upon, their road is so valuable and so important for us that every act of theirs becomes very, very important for us and to stay on that particular road. That is why we've seen the Sahaba Kiram too. When anything used to happen, they used to first see what is the Quran Kareem says, then what the Hadith of Rasulullah SAW is, then what was the Amal of Abu Bakr Siddiq, what was the Amal of Umar radiallahu ta'ala, what was the Amal of Usman radiallahu ta'ala. In fact, the time of gathering the Quran too, it's a long time, we can't go into the detail at this particular time. There too, they were very, very concerned that why can we gather the Quran together in one place when it was not done in the time of Rasulullah SAW. And then Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq was confirmed, thought now this is necessary, conditions of that nature. Hazrat Umar thought is necessary. Then the other Sahaba, they made Mashura and they took that particular path. So to hold steadfastly in the Sunnah of Rasulullah SAW, that is our remedy. If we have iman, there is nothing to fear us, as long as we stay connected to Allah. As long as we stay connected to Rasulullah SAW, as long as we stay connected to the masjid. Today there is a concentrated effort to take us away from the masjid, my dear brothers. And at that time, it is so necessary for us to stay connected to the masjid. Connected to the Akabirin and Musulmani deen. If you stay connected to our elders, you will stay from every sort of difficulty. Great effort is being. Imagine in the masjid that is a super spreader disease. And the moment after the masjid, we are sitting together, we are talking, we are going together, nothing wrong whatsoever. And people have come to understand and taken this to be part and parcel of our lives. So when this sort of thing is mentioned, then you will see what was the life of Akabir and Musulmani deen. They did not leave the masjid. Throughout the Ummah, when any difficulty came, the masjid used to come full. In 95, when we had this very, very, everybody had fear, what is going to happen? Every masjid, every house had Khatmul Quran, had with their tasbihat, zikr, sarqad, etc. Aligning themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and aligning themselves to our Buzurgani deen. This alignment of the Buzurgani deen is so important. I will just mention one incident from the life of our recent Akabirin. We know that in 1947-48, when the partition took place, India-Pakistan partition took place, it was such a severe and such a bad time that nobody knew what to do. Hazrat Mona Yusuf Sahib Rahmatullah Ali came to Hazrat Shaykh al-Hadith Mona Zakaria Sahib Rahmatullah Ali. And he said that most of the people, Punjab had become completely empty virtually. Panipat, which has hundreds of madaris, the big madaris, madrasas, etc., all were turned into churches and stables, etc. Not in churches, into places of worship for the Hindus and into stables, etc. So, at the same time, Hazrat Raipur, there were three great Akabirin, many great Akabirin, but the three are very, very strong. There were three bodies like three different people, but one roof. Hazrat Mullah Zakaria Sahib Rahmatullah Ali, Hazrat Shaykh al-Hadith Mullah Zakaria Sahib Rahmatullah Ali, Hazrat Mullah Badani Rahmatullah Ali, and Hazrat Raipuri Rahmatullah Ali. Hazrat Mullah Yusuf was younger, he was a son-in-law of Hazrat Shaykh al-Hadith Rahmatullah Ali. So he also was a court now, most of the people are gone, so we should also go. Hazrat Raipuri Rahmatullah Ali also came to Mullah Zakaria Sahib Rahmatullah Ali and said that now, there's nothing left here. Only Delhi people are there. Some Punjab had become empty. Most of UP people had gone already to the places to be repatriated to Pakistan. So he also thought, now we should go. Hadhrat Shaykh al-Hadith Rahmanah said that I do not take any decision until I do not make mashur with my two akabirin. And the two akabirin was the Raifudi Rahmatullah and Hadhrat Madin Rahmatullah. So he said when the three akabirin got together, then the mashura took place. Now what to do? Most of the people have gone to the camps already. Hazrat Mani Rahmullah took a deep breath. He said, we tried this partition not to take place, but Allah has willed the partition to come. Until one Muslim remains in this part of the world, Hussein Ahmad will not leave this place. And the Shaykh al-Hadith and Zakariya Salman said that my living and dying with wherever Hazrat Mani is, Zakariya will be there. My living too, my dying too will be with Hazrat Mani. There's a very famous hidden also, and at one time Hazrat Shaykh himself was Hazrat Late Waliyo his time, and Hazrat Mani promised him something. And then as the Shaykh said, you promised me, he said that this was upstairs, that I will not go into Jinnat without you. As the Raipuri Rahmanah said, when you two are going to be here, what am I going to do in Pakistan? When the people heard that the three are Kabirin, they are not going, they are not leaving India and going into Pakistan, then the thousands of people that had gone into the camps, otherwise Darul Diyoban would not have been there. How Punjab had become empty, all those places would have become empty. That was a link with our Qabirin and Buzrukhani Deen. That is why the Shaykh al-Hadith writes in one place, that people say, you talk of your Qabirin, your Buzrukhani Deen, what can I do that every act of my Buzruks, I see it according to Sunnah. If I want to study Sunnah, and I want to see the replica of the Sunnah, that is why in the Ayat of the Quran al-Kareem, Allah Ta'ala says, Anamta alayhim, and who are namunam alayhim? Siddiqeen, Shuhada, Salihin. The Salihin are those whose lives are broken the Sunnah. And by living them, the love of Rasulullah comes to our heart. And we live upon the Sunnah, my dear brothers. Alhamdulillah, in this masjid, great effort was made. In our country, this was one of the few masjids that in difficult times also, with the effort of Hazrat Moulana Rahmatullah Alayhi and the other brothers around, the other ulama and all the other brothers around, that effort was made. They were prepared to go to jail too. Police also came. They made sure that this masjid alhamdulillah they were open. They made sure that Jamaat would continue in this particular masjid. They made sure that no batil would come to this masjid. Now it is our chance to see, to follow life of this Akabirin, Hazrat Moulana Yusuf Rahmatullah Alayhi. The precedent he had set of keeping this masjid with haq under all circumstances. Conditions will come. This dunya is darul imtihan. Conditions will come. Allah says that we will test you. How is it possible that you can just enter Jannah in a easy way like that? But because we are very, very weak, our test will be very, very easy. All we have to do is to align ourselves with Rabbul Zulqarnain. Make certain sacrifices. We cannot please everyone. We have to please only Allah. Please Allah's Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Align ourselves with Buzukani Deen, that join us with this, with the Sahaba Kiram, with Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And inshallah, whatever halat will come, whatever conditions will come, you'll be saved. So that is why you can see, my dear brothers, that when we will align ourselves, and that great effort was made in bringing this masjid, and the masjid is not the four walls of the masjid, that is not a masjid. Amal of the masjid is most important. That amal of the masjid in today's too, when the jali fitna will be there, this masjid will protect us. When we will align ourselves to Quran al-Kareem, we will read our salat with jamaat, we will correct our salat, read our namaz with ta'adil al-arkan, make dua, open the doors. Dua is such a great weapon we have. And let us be sincere, how much time do we spend in dua? In one hadith, Rasulullah says, may yurid Allah bi khairan yaftah lahu abwaab ad-dua. That person whom Allah wishes good, Allah opens the doors of dua for him. What the doors of dua for him, that will be a subject on his own, my dear brothers. But let us take our time and cry in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no more greater ibadah than dua, because a person belittles him. And there is one hadith it comes, that sometimes the dua, Allah Ta'ala does not accept for only one reason, that Allah likes the cry of the banda so much. Allah likes the humility of the banda so much, that Allah for years is delayed, and Allah delays it because Allah likes that cry. That is why the ulama say that we are not here to order Allah Ta'ala. Our job is to ask Allah Ta'ala. And here we have to ask, Ihdina Sirat Mustaqim, Ya Allah, keep us on a straight path. Keep us our language of our kabirin, our buzuqanilin. Save our iman and the progeny of our progeny till the day of Qiyamah. And therefore the Quran Kareem is there. The Hadith Path is there. The Kitab Rizma of our kabirin, which is Noor. When you read those Kitabs, Noor will come to our hearts, inshallah. Surah Kahf is there. The sort of the fitnas that are taking place are definitely a fitness of Dajjal. And the only protection from the Dajjali fitna will be deen. No other thing will be able to protect a person. It comes in the hadith itself that when a person commits a certain wrong, then a black dog comes in his heart. In fact, Hazrat Huzaifa radiallahu ta'ala, who knew the secret of Islam, says that a sign I heard from Rasul, a sign that a person has become black is this, that the recognition between right and wrong goes. By committing guna and not making istighfar and tawbah, slowly, one black spot comes. And then a person comes and he regards the wrong as right and the right as wrong. Then he goes further. He commands what is wrong and he forbids what is right, my dear brothers. So you'll be forbidden. People say, don't come to the masjid. People say, don't align yourself there. We align ourselves to the masjid. We will make Allah's house abad. Allah Ta'ala will make us abad. Wherever we go, if we please Allah, it's fazil. Even Nabi Al Islam advised Abdullah ibn Abbas one time, guard the commandments of Allah Ta'ala and Allah will look after you. What we have to do, our job is this, to fulfill Allah's commandments as far as possible. Then whatever laws are there, we have to break the law and we have to face the consequences, it's a different matter. Then we get istighfar and tawbah, Ya Allah, we are weak people. So Allah grant us tawfiq, my dear brothers, to the present Hazrat Maulana Yunus Sabran has said, of and his other satis that have said, as far as our masjid is concerned, and all our masjid, Allah keep them open, inshallah. Allah keep them abad wa amala, inshallah. Allah make us all, inshallah, on the day of Qiyamah, at the feet of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, at the feet of the Sahaba kiram, every Sahabi's love, my dear brothers, should come to our heart, inshallah. And the way to that is follow the Akabirin. When we follow the Akabirin, automatically we'll be following the Sahaba kiram. And we'll find the Sahaba Kiram, inshallah, tomorrow on the day of Qiyam, we'll come to Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah grant me the tawfiq, Allah grant all the tawfiq, my dear brothers. Mark, that don't look at the glitter of this world, the glitter will be a dhokha. There's the akhirah that has come, your death is to come, your real life will come after death, to prepare for the life of the death. So Allah grant me the tawfiq, Allah grant all the tawfiq to make this effort, inshallah. And keep this, that every masjid abad, and keep us aligned to our Akabirin and Muzruganideen, to save our iman and to save the progeny of our iman. And Allah Ta'ala save each and every person and all the fitnas that are in the world. Allah save us, grant the tawfiq, guarding our eyes, guarding our tongues. The tongue Allah has given us for his yaad, for his zikr. Allah grant us tawfiq of constant zikr of Allah Ta'ala, constant durur upon our beloved Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Come in hadith, inna ulan nas bi yawm al qiyamah. Closest to Rasul Islam, that person who reads the most durur. And as Hazrat Moulana Hamid Sahib was just saying now, that when a person does not have a shaykh, he's in a place also, Hazrat Thanvir Hamid also is in one particular place, then by excessive durood, Allah Ta'ala will guide that person to do the right thing. And there are many instances of that particular nature. So Allah Ta'ala grant us tawfiq be on this way, inshallah, to emulate our Kabirin, to emulate the Sahaba, to emulate Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and inshallah make so that Allah Ta'ala makes among those people on behalf that on whom Nabi will intercede on the day of Qiyamah. And to adopt those amal of shafaat, one of the amal of shafaat, we are very, very weak. The azan takes place when we are talking. Whereas our beloved Nabi alayhi salam said that answer the azan, as the muazzin says, read the small dua that Nabi alayhi salam taught after that, asking for shafaat, and on the day of Qiyamah you will get my intercession. What an easy way. In one hadith, Nabi alayhi salam says, whenever you make wuzu, make miswak. It comes in a hadith, a person who makes miswak at all times, inshallah, the least that will happen, besides all the other benefits, that at the time of death, Allah will come to tawfiq of reading the kalima. He is a small soul. That means when we have the tawfiq of reading the kalima, he will be protected from the jahad. He will be protected from shayatin al jinn wal ins. And he will be protected from all the evil that we see around us, my dear brothers. So Allah grant us tawfiq of adopting every beautiful sunnah of Rasulullah Sallam, bring the true love of our beloved Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, and to see how Nabi alayhi salam first see the life of our kabirin, then finally we will see the life of Rasulullah Sallam. Allah grants all the tawfiq, inshallah, and protect all of us till the day of Qiyamah. And inshallah, Allah keep this masjid, every masjid abad, with the masjid and the amal masjid. And the challenges come, we make dua to Allah, Ya Allah, don't put us to stress, we are very, very weak. But if we have to come to a challenge, if the challenge comes, Allah Ta'ala grant tawfiq, istiqamah to be firm, and not be a means of fitna, and not be a means of creating barriers in the work of deen. Wa akhru da'wan alhamdulillah alameen. Actually, Hazrat, we should be living to Hazrat Mawlana Abdul Hamid Sahib. So I really ask for forgiveness for speaking in a company or in a presence of Hazrat Mawlana Mandazilluhu.